Typhoon Egay makes landfall over Fuga Island in Apari, Cagayan. Let's get an update on the track of the typhoon from PAGASA weather forecaster Veronica Torres. Good morning, Veronica. Go ahead.
Good morning, Sneaky, and to all of our audience. You're right. So Egay made landfall over Fuga Island, Apari, Cagayan. And as of 4 a.m. today, the center of the eye of Typhoon Egay was estimated based on all available data over the coastal waters of Apari, Cagayan, with maximum sustained winds of 175 kilometers near the center and gustiness up to 240 kilometers per hour. Currently, it's moving westward with a speed of 20 kilometers per hour. And because of Egay, their signal number 4 raised over the northern portion of Cagayan, including Babayan Island, northern portion of Apayao, and the northern portion of Ilocos Norte. While signal number 3 is raised over Batanes, the rest of Cagayan, the rest of Apayao, the northern portion of Caninga, the northern portion of Abra, the rest of Ilocos Norte, and the northern portion of Ilocos Sur. Signal number 2 is raised over Isabela, the rest of Caninga, Mountain Province, Ifugao, Benguet, the rest of Abra, the rest of Ilocos Sur, and La Union, while signal number 1 is raised over Aurora, Quirino, Nueva Vizcaya, Pangasinan, Nueva Ecija, Tarlac, Pampanga, Bulacan, Zambales, Bataan, Metro Manila, Rizal, Cavite, Laguna, the northern portion of Batangas, the northern portion of Quezon, including Polillo Islands, Camarines Norte, the northern portion of Camarines Sur, and the northern portion of Catanduanes. And as of now, we also have a gale warning over the seaboards of Luzon and Visayas. And a landfall over the northwestern Cagayan is also not ruled out, and it's expected to exceed the Philippine area of responsibility tomorrow morning. The next tropical cyclone bulletin will be issued at 8 a.m. today. And that's the latest from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center, Veronica Torres.
All right. Thanks, Veronica. You stay safe and you stay dry. Nearly 17,000 individuals affected by Typhoon Egay and the southwest monsoon, based on latest data from the country's Disaster Management Agency. In Santa Ana, Cagayan, over 400 families were evacuated due to the threat of the storm. The town is experiencing heavy rains and strong winds. Blackouts were also reported in some areas.
Yung storm surge sa tagal po namin dito, slight lang naman po yung apekto ng storm surge based on yung mga nakaraan po. Pero yung flash flood po talaga ang matindi dito, lalong-lalo dito sa mga inner barangays po. Kagaya pong nakaraan na talagang binaha po yung interior barangay.
In Puerto Princesa City, Palawan, some areas experienced flooding. Dozens of families affected by the floods were evacuated. Now in Cebu, hundreds of passengers are stranded in ports as rough seas and strong winds persist. Metro Manila was not spared from Typhoon Egay as heavy rains trigger flooding in some areas. Let's get an update from our correspondent Liza Aquino. Liza, what do you have for us? What can you tell us there?
Nikki, strong winds and continuous heavy rains battered parts of Metro Manila brought by Typhoon Egay, also known from its international name, Doksuri. In Valenzuela City, motorists were greeted with knee-deep floods in some parts of Arcong Bato, one of the major roads in the city. Nikki, I'm currently here in the said area, and as you can see behind me, the said road is still submerged in flood, in gutter-deep flood, but, you know, motorists are still flying this area. And if you guys are here, for all of those watching right now, if you're here in Arcong Bato, going to the direction of MH Del Pilar and Malabon City, we're currently experiencing moderate and heavy rains in the area because of the flooding. According to the latest advisory from the Valenzuela City Command Control and Communication Center, gutter deep floods are also still being reported in the following areas: MacArthur Highway in Dalandanan, T. Santiago Street, and in Navarrete Street, while floods estimated to be 10 to 12 inches deep are reported along G. Lazaro Street, corner Fernando, still in Valenzuela City. Meanwhile, in Malabon City, gutter deep floods were reported along MH Del Pilar, Barangay Maysilo, and Tatawid intersection. Some parts of Rizal Avenue, corner C3 Road in Caloocan, were also submerged in flood around 3 in the morning, as well as a portion of Araneta Avenue in Quezon City. All affected roads are passable to all kinds of vehicles as of this hour. PAGASA earlier raised the yellow rainfall warning in the said cities which means that flooding is possible or possible, especially in low-lying areas. Back to you.
Liza, apart from the flooding, how's the weather there looking right now?
Right now, we're experiencing light to moderate rains in the area. But as of now, we're still experiencing the flood here and we're experiencing heavy winds as of this moment.
All right. You and the team stay safe. Thanks again, Liza. Egay, with the international name of Doksuri, is also threatening China. Doksuri is forecast to be the most powerful typhoon to hit China this year after the country narrowly escaped the wrath of Mawar. Torrential rains have pounded China in recent days, flooding several towns. Local authorities have organized rescue and relief operations in affected areas. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. assures Filipinos in Malaysia their welfare will be among government's main priorities. The speaking in front of the Filipino community in Kuala Lumpur, Marcos vowed to address issues and challenges hounding the migrant sector. He also lauded OFWs for maintaining the country's good reputation abroad.
Isa na ito na ating pag-iikot upang siyempre kailangan natin patibayin ang relasyon ng Pilipinas at saka ng Malaysia. Unang-una dahil napakaraming Pilipino rito. At kaya kailangan natin tiyakin na lahat kayo ay naaalagaan at lahat kayo ay maayos ang kabuhayan at nabibigyan ng mga pagkakataon kung bakit kayo lumipat at umalis sa Pilipinas ay para nga dito sa mga opportunities na nakikita ninyo rito. Ngunit kailangan namin tiyakin na yung mga opportunity na yan ay nandiyan pa rin. At habang kayo yung nagtatrabaho dito, hindi naman kayo nahihirapan.
Marcos arrived in Malaysia Tuesday afternoon for a state visit. He is set to meet with Malaysia's King and Prime Minister as well as business leaders during his trip. The Philippine government heading in the right direction in achieving its 2023 growth target. That's according, at least, to the National Economic and Development Authority, citing the ongoing downtrend of inflation. Economic managers are projecting a 6 to 7% growth for this year. NEDA Chief Arsenio Balisacan says the country only needs to post an average growth of 5.9% in the next three quarters to attain this target. Balisacan also vows to work on Marcos's economic promises during his second State of the Nation address. These include sustaining the country's high growth momentum, improving labor market conditions, as well as ensuring steady easing of inflation.
All of government, all of society abroad, as I said earlier, we need to focus on raising productivity. Of course, that's both short term and long term. We need to focus on the logistics. We need to focus on markets and the information that's available in making decisions about availability of and adequacy of food supply.